change here. You good? Okay. So let's stop there for a second. So you're learning, your rabbi's teaching about chen, you're taking what you're learning, you're digging into the Torah, and you're starting to connect these dots.
And probably realize exactly what's going on there.
But you started writing a book about chen. When you started writing this book is when you started seeing the connections to Christianity and to Yeshua. So you weren't looking for it.
Everything just came.
Okay.
Okay. Yes.
And so when did you start writing the book? When was this?
This was almost 33 years ago.
Okay. And how much did you write initially? I mean, like, how you know, was this just what? Tell us a little bit about the.
Well, I start to write my book. I wrote it four times. The two first time was chaos. It was just my first work about this. So it was maybe 2,000 pages. It was full of gematriot, much too much for anybody. It was completely not a correct way of writing, the way he was writing, etc. So it was my first collecting of the effect about the gematriot, etc. It's like just to put together all the knowledge, fake knowledge in the letter of the Torah that is relevant. I put it there together.
And keep in mind, his rabbi has published probably over 100.
Over
100 books. Okay, so his rabbi, you know, if his rabbi is editing your first draft manuscript, you know, it's gonna be tough, right? especially given the subject matter.
One of the deal between us that he will put his comment in my book, he will put his name in my book,
comments,
and he will translate it to English. Now, it is another book. It was a second book that. Of course, it was not yet ready, and then I wrote this book, what we call it Yimar Shimo, The Curse, All the Secret of Chen of Mashiach, hiding in these three letters. Yimar equal Chen. We're talking about three special words that have the acronym of Yimar, that all the book is based on it. What is Yitzhak?
So Yimar Shimo, translate that to English.
His name will be Erez.
So it means Yimach will be...
His name will be blotted out.
Right, blotted out. Shemo is his name. Yimach will be blotted out, will be erased.
That's the name of his book?
That's the name of his book.
So Yimach equaling Yimet Yachem. It's like I would say that his name is Chen, the name of Mashiach. One of the name of Mashiach is Yinon, equal Chen Chen. There are many hints in the name of Mashiach that have to do with Chen, of course. And when I wrote the introduction in my first book, 32 years ago, I wrote this book based on three concepts. Yitzhak is the hero of the story, Mashiach is the goal of the story, Chen is the key of Yitzhak to achieve this goal. After a while, I realized that I have here the acronym of Yimach.
Okay, so
there I just give example how Christianity start to appear here.
So Yimach, correct me if I'm wrong, Yimach in Hebrew is spelled Yud Mem Chet. And those three letters are an acronym, Yitzhak, Mashiach, Chet.
Oh.
Okay.
I base all my learning, my everything that I find about Mashiach, I base it on this three words, Yitzhak, Mashiach, Chen, that has the acronym of Yimach.
Okay. But what's the significance of the expression Yimach Shmo? Why is that significant with respect to Messiah, with respect to Yeshua in particular?
Well, we show that really in the holy language, in the holy tongue, curse don't exist. All the curse is just blessing, it's just a question of going deep to the letter. The most deep intention in the priest blessing is in Marshimo. I am a priest. So every time I do the priest blessing to the people, then I came to them, I told them, you know what is the most important meaning of this blessing? Yimach Shemo. Your name would be Erez, all right? So.
But Orthodox Jews, when they refer to Yeshu, they often say this expression, right?
Every time somebody will mention his name, Yeshu, the reaction will be immediately Yimach Shemo.
It's
like an automatic reaction to hear the name of Jesus.
And so Orthodox Judaism has this tradition of saying this expression anytime somebody refers to Yeshu, Jesus, okay? And in their mind, they think they're saying a curse. What Ariel is saying is
it's taboo.
Right, it's taboo, because Yeshua is taboo in Judaism, right? And there's all kinds of reasons for that. That's a whole other discussion in class. But the point is, they say this phrase. It's intended to be a curse, but what Ariel is saying is, in reality, they're actually pronouncing a blessing and don't even know it. Okay? So, that's why his book is named Yimach Shmo.
Yimach Shmo, you can see that the first four letters here is the letter of Mashiach. Mashiach.
Okay.
This is one of thousand things that you can see when you go to this world. Okay, so.
Okay, so you write this book, you do it a couple times over a period of years, you finally get to this version, which right now is only in Hebrew, and you know, hopefully it will be translated to English soon.
It is a book about the book. What is the fourth book that I wrote? It's not instead of the one. It's just so this book contains these two books together, and the book about the book. Somebody work on the translation of it, and I hope that really soon as it. What is possible, we have the book about the book in English.
So, when you begin to unsurface these connections to Yeshua, to Christianity, and you take this back to your rabbi, so again, what was his reaction?
No, yes.
No, yes. No, that
no, lo, ken, and the Moshe. No, lo, ken, and the Moshe.
Ken, lo.
Looks like a cross.
But you can't really argue with your technique, because you're using the techniques he taught you, right?
He teach me things about the cross that I didn't know. You know?
Yeah.
He knew exactly what's going on here.
Yeah.
And give me my his blessing about this. I told him that I'm going to United States to some peace and
conference,
and he sent me his blessing.
So, okay, so you've now been, you know, you're in Jerusalem, you've got your Orthodox community there, you know, people know you've written this book, you go to the shul to pray, you know, what's the reaction of the other Orthodox Jews in the community? How come you haven't gotten
through? I have no problem.
Okay.
Sometimes after the rabbi talk about something, he say something about the Parashat HaShavua. After I go to him to quietly, and you know what you just say, call Yeshua. I say, ah, really?
So this is, I think, one of the things that makes Arya unique in that he's in the Orthodox community, and he's openly, you know, he's out there with the book in the community. He's posting videos on YouTube, so he's exposed, and yet he's still in that community. He's not been, you know, he hasn't been kicked out or whatever. So we talked. We already talked a little bit about the book. So what I want to do now is, because we've got about an hour left, I want you to share a little bit about the connection of Yeshua to Eretz Israel, to the land of Israel, and show us some of the really beautiful mantra that comes through that.
Okay. Okay. First of all, I'd like to say that my book born in the same day that was a disengagement from Gaza, exactly the same day. The day was meant to be Tisha B'Av, and Sharon did know. So they told him, this is Tisha B'Av, you cannot do it in Tisha B'Av, so he moved it to Yud B'Av. Really, the temple was in fire in Yud B'Av as well. And my book was printed in the same year, more of 10 years ago, in Tisha B'Av.
Does everybody understand the significance of Tisha B'Av?
The most terrible day in the...
Okay,
it's the ninth day in the month of Av. In this day happened a lot of big catastrophe in the story of Am Israel. The temple was destroyed two times in this day. The two temples were destroyed in the day of Nine Be'av. The Gerush from Spain was in Tisha B'Av. So there are many bad things that happened in this day. And our Sages said that in Tisha B'Av born Mashiach. Mm. Okay, so my book, that is a book about Mashiach, born in this day.
Okay, so your book is born on Tisha B'Av or Yud B'Av, yeah, as the nation is giving Gaza back to the Palestinians.
Okay, so now we will see the connection of my book to this day of giving Gaza to Ishmael.
Do you need to erase the board?
Yeah, okay.
Their territory, that for some reason the establishment of Medinat Israel didn't decide yet that this territory belonged to Am Israel. This territory called the Yehuda, Shomron, Gaza.
Judah, Samaria, and Gaza. The three areas of Eretz Israel.
In Hebrew it's Gaza, it's not Gaza, it's right. The letter Ayin. They used to call this territory Yesha, when we still have Gush Katif, when we still have the part of land that had to do with Gaza. They used to call it Yesha. The according of this three place is Yehuda, Shomron, Ve. And as I was make the name Yeshua in the right order. Okay, so this is really the name of this place. If I do only the acronym of these three letters, Yehuda, Shomron, Ve, I have the name Yeshua. This is the way we call it in Hebrew. All the other letters equal Yemach Shmo, the name of my book. So Yeshu Yimach Shimo is Yehuda Shomron Ve'Aza. Right, so it's not only the acronym is Yeshu, all the other letters equal Yimach Shimo is exactly the way it's going. Somebody say Yeshu, the action Yimach Shimo. Right, so this is the first thing. Now we lost the Ein, exactly like Yeshua lost the letter Ein.
So the Ayin, the first letter of Gaza, right? We lost it. You're saying we lost it because we gave Gaza away. We gave the land away. Just like Yeshua, that ends with an Ayin, they call him Yeshu. They've lost. He's lost the Ayin.
There are many deep reasons why Yeshua lost the Ayin. The Ayin is a letter that corresponds to the snake, to the evil force, to the Caesar. and he didn't realize in his life the potential of being Mashiach ben David, what have to do with the letter Ein. Ein equals 70, David lived 70 years, etc. There are many things to explain about this. I just say shortly that there are deep reasons why with Ashgacha Pratit, it's not that somebody really
Providence.
Meant to curse him and to say Yimach Shmo v'zichro, that has the acronym of Yeshu. It's not really the case. There are deep reasons why he lost the Ein, and we see that happened exactly the same thing here in Eretz Israel, that we lost Gaza. It means now what we have left, we call it Yosh. What is Yehuda, and we have to put the Vav, Yehuda v'Shomron, Judah and Samaria, is Yosh, what is the same letter of Yeshu. Same letter. Okay, so now what we have left is Jesus with no Ein. And if I do the gematria of Yehuda plus Shomron, equal 2 times Yeshu, 2 times 416. Okay, so the average value of each one of these two names equal is Jesus. Right, so if we are with this number, 2 times Jesus, we must do this gematria. If I do Yudke Vavke, the name of God, what we call the Father, 26, I don't write the name of God on the table, plus Miriam, what is the Mother? What is the Holy Spirit? What is 26 plus 290 equal Yeshu. So, if I have here Yudke Vavke plus Miriam plus Yeshu, all the Trinity equal Yehuda Shomron.
So, one thing to just point out, and Ariel can fill in if I misspeak here, but the significance of Yeshua losing the Ein, right, from Yeshua to Yeshu, is from the perspective of Ariel and from Orthodox Judaism, Messiah is inseparable from the Lamb. Mashiach Israel and Eretz Israel are inseparable. They're eternally connected. So the fact that the Messiah lost his Ein is in one way prophetic of the fact that the land also lost the Ein when Azazel was given away. So, but yet even when they try to divide the land, his name is still, however you want to try to carve it up, his name is still there in the gematria. Now, if you love Israel, if you love the land, if you love Yeshua, if that doesn't bless you, check your pulse, because your blesser is probably busted. Okay? Because that is, that's not just coincidence, and he could spend a long time, many hours, giving lots and lots of examples of how these themes of Yeshua, Mashiach, Yitzhak, Hen, all of these concepts are just over and over embedded in the Gematria throughout the Torah.
Is that very open within Orthodox Judaism, or do they just not talk about it?
Right now, I don't put any energy to talk to Jewish people. It's not legal. And before it's legal, I have to stay like this. Right now, I talk especially to Neshen. I teach myself to talk to Neshen. It's a learning for me too, how to talk to them. I know that I can talk with Jewish people in a good way, that it will be not a catastrophe after this. In the moment, we will be ready, my rab and me, 100% acceptance about what we are going to do.
So Ariel, before you.
One second.